Hello everyone, and welcome to this quick video where I'm going to go through what you can expect if you choose to study higher modern studies at Dice Academy. So what are the different parts of the course? What can you expect to look at if you decide to go with modern studies at higher level? So the course content at Higher Modern Studies is split into three different units. Now, different schools might do slightly different things because in some of the units, there's kind of a choice that schools make about what it is that they want to look at. So different schools might do slightly different things when it comes to their units, but we've got our three at Dice that we do. And our first unit that we do is social inequalities in the UK, and this is our kind of social issues in the UK unit. So we look at lots of things in this unit. We look at why some people in the UK and in Scotland too, why some people are richer than others and why some people are poorer, and what are some of the causes behind these inequalities, kind of when it comes to poverty, how geography plays a part, how education plays a part, how maybe lots of different factors play a part in how much money somebody has. So that's wealth inequalities. We look at health inequalities. Why are some people in the UK much healthier than other people? What are the factors that are involved here? And in looking at these inequalities, we touch on gender issues, we touch on kind of racial issues, and how kind of they're all involved when we look at these sort of inequalities. So as you'll see in all of Higher Modern Studies, lots of room for discussion of these controversial and important social and political issues that affect all of us in our society. So we look at those inequalities, then we look at what the government has been doing to try and address those inequalities. What have they tried to do to reduce this gap that exists between the wealthiest and the poorest in society, and the gap between the healthiest and the unhealthiest in society? How has the government responded? So we look at that. We also do a bit of a look at kind of different ways of thinking about how society works. Should we be a society where everyone is on their own, they just focus on themselves, and that way you'll be able to, if you work hard enough, get enough money to kind of deal with any problems that you face? Or should we have a more kind of what we call a collectivist society where we all help each other out and we've got a sense of community going on, but that's maybe going to be more expensive and maybe people are going to have to pay more taxes? And is that fair if some people are just reaping the rewards of this society and not contributing that much? So that in a nutshell is one of our units, our social inequalities unit. Next, we have our second unit, which is democracy in Scotland and the UK. So here we look at how decisions are made in Scotland and how that compares to in the United Kingdom as a whole. So for those of you who have done National 5 Modern Studies, this is going to be building on kind of what you've covered there and expanding it to think about Scotland and the UK together, looking at how we vote for the people who represent us, kind of what the role is of those people who represent us, whether they kind of form the government and what the government does, or whether they're part of the wider parliament and what their role is, and how does the parliament hold the government to account? How do they make sure that kind of the prime minister or first minister isn't going rogue and doing whatever they want to? And as part of that unit, we look at kind of key political issues as well. We look at the arguments for Scottish independence, about whether Scotland should become independent or whether there are other options out there. What are the arguments there? We discuss the European Union, this issue of Brexit that has kind of torn the UK apart. We look at kind of that issue in some detail as well. So lots of things all to do with how decisions are made in Scotland and the UK and kind of what decisions they make, kind of analysing that in a bit of detail. So that's two units. Our last unit, you get a choice at higher level as a school about what you're going to focus on, either an international issue or an international power, a world power. And we at DICE, we are going to stay focused on the USA as an international power, just because there's so much going on in the USA right now. It's kind of difficult to kind of go with something else when kind of all we've seen through kind of Trump's administration from his election through to now, even kind of with the presidential election last year with Joe Biden beating Trump, but then Trump refusing to accept the result, and then the Capitol Hill riots. And on top of this, we've got the Black Lives Matter protests and all these other issues going on in America. It's just such a fascinating country to look at and make comparisons with the UK. So we're going to look at the USA as a world power. We look at it from kind of a global perspective. How much influence does it have over the whole world? We look at it from a political perspective about how people, whether they can participate or not in American politics, kind of how the system works, the system of checks and balances that exists between the different kind of branches of the US federal government. And we also look at social issues in the USA. So kind of building on what we look at in our first unit for the UK, we consider that from an American perspective and think about it kind of from how the USA deals with these social issues and what, in fact, what social issues and inequalities does it face. So that is what we look at in our USA unit. So together that gives us our three units at Higher Modern Studies. In addition to those three units, we also have a section of source questions, which builds on what we cover at National 5 Modern Studies. So again, there's three source questions, but this time they are what we call, we've got kind of an objectivity question, where you're looking at a statement and an evidence that supports and opposes it before coming to a final overall conclusion as to how accurate that statement is. We have got a reliability question, where actually we look at sources of information themselves and how reliable the sources are. Are they kind of, is the information up to date and correct? Do we know the purpose of the information? Is there any evidence in the sources? Is it presented well? So how do we know that the sources of information that we look at, how do we know that it is reliable? And then our final source question, it's a conclusions question. Again, similar to what we did in National 5, if you did National 5, but instead we've only got three kind of conclusion topics, and then we form an overall conclusion based on the information in the sources. So we've got those source questions that make up a kind of significant portion of the course as well. In addition to that, we have space for our Higher Modern Studies assignment, where you get to pick a topic that you are interested in from across all of modern studies and spend some more time looking at it, researching it, and producing an assignment report based on your research and different arguments related to that issue. And then we have a final write-up in class where you get to kind of put down and show off all you've researched for your assignment. So that's the last component of Higher Modern Studies. So I hope that gives you a bit of a flavor about what you can expect if you choose to study Higher Modern Studies at DICE and all that is involved in the course. So we've got our three units of content: social inequalities in the UK, democracy in Scotland and the UK, and the USA as a world power. We've got our three source questions and we've got our assignment. And together, that is our course. Lots of room to hear your opinions, to discuss these really important and controversial issues, to get debate going both in our conversations, but also in what you're going to put in your essay and exam answers. So thanks very much for watching. Hope you found this useful and I'll see you later on. Take care.